blood of Jesus is our atonement. We are looking at the power of the blood of Jesus and what the blood of Jesus has done for us. Let me read for us from the Word of God. I'm reading from Matthew 26 and verse 28. It says, "For this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for many for the remission of sins." So the blood of Jesus, Jesus spoke these words. He said that my blood was shed for the remission of sins. Now in the Old Testament, we see this concept called atonement. Atonement is nothing but the cancellation. It's the annulling, or it's the covering of sin. And for atonement, what was done is that animals would be taken to the temple and they would be sacrificed. And their blood would cover the sins of the people. But this had to be done repeatedly. This had to be done on various occasions because the blood of animals was not powerful enough to forgive every sin and every wrongdoing. So the concept of atonement comes from there, where mankind recognizes that there is a need for the shedding of blood, for the covering of our sin. What Jesus is saying in this passage is that his blood is the blood of the new covenant. The new covenant, which is this blood is shed for the remission of sins of many. So the Lamb of God, which needed to be slain for our sins to be covered, for our sins to be cancelled, is Jesus himself. Which is why even when John the Baptist meets Jesus, Jesus is his cousin, and yet when he sees Jesus, the statement that John the Baptist says is, "Behold the Lamb of God," the Lamb of God who would go ahead and shed his blood, who would die on the cross, and through the blood of Jesus, the sins of mankind would be covered. So Jesus is that Lamb of God. But the beautiful thing about Jesus being the Lamb of God is that the way the Old Testament sacrifices needed to be done every day, that doesn't have to be done anymore. Jesus, when we study the book of Hebrews, we understand that he is that one perfect sacrifice. The requirement for a perfect sacrifice to be sinless, to be spotless, to be blemishless, that was found in Jesus, in the way he lived his life. Though he was fully man and he was fully God, Jesus lived that powerful, sinless life. And so when he became our sacrifice on the cross, his blood has covered all our sins. We need not go running behind anyone or anything else to cancel our sins. And the shedding of the blood of Jesus has done this powerful and mighty work for us, that once for all, this perfect sacrifice has covered not only the sins of one or two people, but the sins of all mankind. Anyone who believes, the power of this blood is demonstrated in their lives. So as we just meditate on the blood of Jesus and the power of the blood of Jesus, now let's get a deep insight on the atonement of the blood of Jesus, which is that the blood of Jesus has stood to cover all our sins. Can we pray together this day? Heavenly Father, we thank you for your love toward us. And God, though the blood of bulls, oh God, the blood of lambs, Father, and all kinds of animals could not wash away our sin, God, thank you that you yourself chose to become that one sacrifice for us, oh God. I just pray that those who are listening to me, God, that they would experience the power of this blood, God, that their sins be forgiven, Father, and that, Lord, they would experience a freedom, oh God. They would experience the blessings of God come upon them, because through your blood, Lord, our sins are forgiven. Father, we give you thanks, Lord. We give you praise for the power of the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.